Today's meditation I want to take from Matthew chapter 17 verse 20. Matthew chapter 17 verse 20. If anyone read for me, that will be great help. Very easy, no? Matthew chapter 17 verse 20. Yeah, 20. Nothing will be impossible for you. Hallelujah. This is the Rhema word God is giving to us. Nothing shall be impossible for you or God. For you. Hallelujah. My dear brother and sister, all this day we knew one thing. Nothing is impossible to the Lord. Today the Lord is telling us nothing is impossible to you and me. If any man tell like this, we may think that he is trying to butter me. He is trying to please me. But here, the Lord, Almighty God, Jesus Christ, the one who never said lie, one who never compromised with the people, he said, nothing is impossible to you. My dear brother and sister, God is a God, he is always taking us to one level to another level. He never satisfied. Our God is not the satisfied God. How many of you believe? He is not a satisfied God. You always want to give more. No, John chapter 1 verse 50, Nathanael, when he heard the prophecy of God, he was amazed. Jesus told to Nathanael, Nathanael, don't be panic, don't be amazed. I have seen you while you were standing under the fig tree. But he was amazed. Oh, how he knew. But he said, this is nothing you will see greater than this. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy chapter 1 verse 11. The Moses prophesied over his God's people. Like today, you will increase in thousands. During the time, when you see their calculation is amazing. When Jacob entered the land of Egypt with all his children, the Bible said they were 70 numbers. But after the 430 years, they become 30 lakhs people. How many percent? Bishop told it will write. 600,000. Oh, double. 600,000. 6 lakhs, huh? 600,000 men, no? Only men. Then you calculate the family and everything. It comes all around 30 lakhs. 2 million. 20 lakhs then. 2 million. So 70 become 2 million. Now the Lord said, this is not enough. You have to increase in thousands. Then 2 million into 1,000? 2,000 million. He will not say, oh, this is not enough. Increase more. Heart of God's Father's heart. If you go and tell that pastor, Jesus, I sanctified. I am holy. Then what the Lord will say? More holy. Lord, I blessed, I cast out a thousand demons. Then the Lord said, this is not enough. Cast out all the demons. So the Bible, Jesus is always wants us to go to one level to another level. One blessing to another blessing. Until we enter the kingdom of God will not satisfy. He wants to give more blessing. Oh, you faithful in little one, have some more. You faithful in some more, have more. Hallelujah. The same way here, the Lord wants to take us from one level to another level. There was a day we thought that it may be impossible to God. For example, Luke chapter 1, when you read the Mary, that Lord, the angel appeared before Mary and said, Mary, you are a blessed one. You are going to conceive. You are going to bear Jesus Christ, the Savior, Emmanuel. Then, what was a reply from Mary? How can it possible? Luke chapter 1, from 30 it comes, I think so. No, how can it possible? Because from the beginning of the year, there was no evidence, there was no incident happened without husband, no woman conceived. No virgin bear the child. But the prophecy of God came to Mary, you are going to bear the child. Then the angel of God explained, the Holy Spirit will come to you. Right? Then he said, nothing is impossible to the Lord. The same way in our life also, we may thought that I cannot save. We may thought that I cannot heal. We may thought that this cannot happen. But the Holy Spirit came in our life. The God came in our life and He performed the miracle. Now we started believing nothing is impossible to the Lord. Do you know there is a growth in our life, you know? There was a day we never believed. Nowadays we are believing everything. The situation says this is impossible. We are telling nothing is impossible to the Lord. I think you catch my point. Right? So we groan in a spiritual life. We groan in a supernatural experience. My dear brother, there was a day Peter, he doubted, but there was a day came, he ready to give his life to God. Like that God called. Once you know my testimony. Once I successfully passed my plus two, higher second in the eighth time, I went to my father and said that, Pastor, Daddy, I passed. Then he said, Now I trust Jesus as a power. Now I believe Jesus, nothing is impossible to God. So the promotion came. So there was a day we thought that I cannot be a blessing. Now we can say that, oh, Jesus made me blessing to many people. Nothing is impossible to the Lord. But God is not satisfied. He said, nothing is impossible to God. It's okay. Now you need to believe nothing is impossible to you. Amen. Nothing is impossible to you. That is the heart of Father. When you read John chapter 14 verse 12, please read what Bible says. John chapter 14 verse 12. What is the meaning of most assuredly, sister? When you use most assuredly word, that means you cannot believable. I am assuredly, most assuredly. Assuredly, most assuredly means the greater than the assurance. My dear brothers, the many places God emphasizes many words. Surely I will tell to you. Rejoice in the Lord. Again I am telling you, rejoice in the Lord. All these things is mentioning one thing. What the Lord is going to convey to us, it cannot be believable, but you have to believe. Here it says, most assuredly I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also, and greater works. Hallelujah. What the prophecy of God? Before Jesus left this world, he said, those who believe me, he will do the work what I did. He will do greater than this. Hallelujah. That's why the Lord said, nothing will impossible to you. Everything will possible to you. If I can cast out the demon, you can able to cast out. If I can over the world, you can able to over the world. Hallelujah. That's why the John chapter 16 verse 33, the Lord said, in me you must have peace, so that I am telling these things to you. In this world you will have the troubles, but behold, I overcome the world. If you overcome, the Bible says, we are more than conquerors. If Jesus is an overcomer, we are more than overcomer. Today, my dear brother and sister, God is expecting this has to come in our heart. Many churches, many pastors, we are believing nothing is impossible to the Lord. Today, we have to believe this thing, nothing is impossible who believe Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. My dear brother and sister, when you compare to Jesus' ministry, the greater miracles apostles did. In Jesus' ministry, you never hear that no one healed by his shadow. Right? But Bible says when Peter walked, what happened? He didn't have the time to stand and pray. Multitude followed. Whoever walked just in the shadow, they healed. You know, the Paul belt had the miracle power. Paul kerchief, it had the miracle power. More than Jesus. My dear brother and sister, that's why the Bible says nothing is impossible to you. Jesus walked over the sea, but through Moses, God opened the sea. Do you believe what is a miracle? Amazing miracle God has done. The Jordan went behind when the God's people stepped into the water. When people walked by faith, Jericho wall trembled. Amazing things God has done. In Bible, we can find lots of impossible things happened by the normal people. Hallelujah. How many are happy today? The same God is telling to you today, in this place, in this United Kingdom, He is going to do impossible things possible through you and me. Hallelujah. Nothing is impossible to the Lord. That is one side. Nothing is impossible to one who believes Jesus Christ. One who trusts Jesus Christ. My dear brother and sister, in Bible, lots of miracles happen. Can you tell some miracles? Impossible things happen. Can you tell something? All pastors are sitting here. 5,000 fed by 5 bread and 2 fish. Yeah. Water. Blind. Okay. Raise the dead. You see, in all the miracles, you can find one thing that's happened: obedience of God's people. They just obey what the Lord said. Today, we are celebrating, church is celebrating 500 years of Reformation. In 1517, October 31st, Reformation written by Martin Luther King Sr. Right? What happened? My dear brother and sister, all this day, the church, they worked just against the word of God. What is the Reformation? The church decided we have to obey the word of God. Why the Protestant system came? Why the Baptist came? Why the Methodist came? Why the Anglican came? Why these Pentecostal people came? Why we came out, my dear brother and sister? We decided hereafter we will not obey what the world is telling. We will obey what the Bible says. When church started believing the word of God, my dear brother and sister, all the impossible things become possible. First 3 centuries, the golden era of the Christianity. First 3 centuries, during that time, there is no technology. During that time, there is no proper Bible. During that time, there is no any facility. During that time, I can tell that there is no government recognized Christianity is the acceptable one. Whole world against the Christianity. Kings were against. Nations were against. Everywhere persecutions. If you said you are a Christian, they will kill you. My dear brother, but during that first 3 centuries, throughout world surrendered before the kingdom of God. Amen. Hallelujah. How many happy today, my brother? Because through the normal people, God has done the impossible things. Through the normal people, people saw the God's power through their ministry. People saw the God's image through their ministry. My dear brothers, they call them, oh, these people are going to shake this place. Today the same God wants to bring the revival in this land. Only one thing, obedience. Hallelujah. When you read 1 Samuel chapter 15, Samuel spoke to Saul. We can read that also. 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 22. The Bible says, more than a sacrifice, obedience is better. Hallelujah. Obedience. So what we need to do for obedience? We all know this thing is needed. But what I need to do for obedience? To obey the God's word, only one thing we have to do. We should not allow our brain to work. When you think, you cannot obey. Nowadays, people are growing in the worldly knowledge so that they couldn't able to obey. Every miracle God has done in an unmeasurable way. For example, God changed water as a wine, right? How many of you knew this? Water as a wine, we all knew that. The people came to Mary and said that, Mary, do something. We are in the shortage of wine. Then Mary said, let us go to Jesus. What she said? Whatever he said, obey. Amen. Whatever he said, obey. What he said? We all knew that Jesus turned the water into wine. But God used these people to change the water into wine. These people's obedience allow the God's power to perform the miracle. What the Lord say? Jewish people, they are very hygienic people. They are very clean people. Wherever they go, they clean their feet, they clean their hand, for that they used to have the water to clean their feet. And Jesus what said? Take that water and fill the jar and serve. My dear brother and sister, after Jesus prayed the water and after it changed, serving to the people is very easy. Now you are going to take which water? The water supposed to use for the cleaning your feet. For example, in UK you are blessed, all the taps coming the clean water, right? In India is different. Like in India we have a drinking water, we have the normal water, washing different water, taking bath different water. So if I am asking, Pastor, brother, I need a water. You are going and searching. The drinking water is over. If you take the water from the bathroom, can you give it to me? If you give it to me, can I drink it? Or will you ready to give it to me? Here the same water. The worldly way, it's a foolish thing. Worldly way is impossible. Worldly way, it cannot acceptable. But Jesus said, when they obey, the impossible thing can become possible. My dear brother and sister, the obedience is nothing but without asking any question, believing God. Hallelujah. How many of you happy today, my dear brother and sister? God used Elijah. How many of you believe God used Elijah? Among many, many prophets were there, but few prophets, they brought the revival. So Moses, he brought the revival. Elijah, he brought the revival. Not Elisha. Elisha's life, a lot of miracle happened, but that miracle was not led the people to the repentance. But through the Elijah, people came to the repentance. Through the Moses, people came to the repentance. My dear brother and sister, whenever God that does the amazing thing, people will come and repent. Right? So in 1 Samuel chapter 18, the Lord spoke to Elijah, Elijah, go and show yourself before King Ahab. What do you know the King Ahab? Is a good guy or bad guy? When you read 1 Samuel chapter 18, the Bible, 1 Kings chapter 18, Bible says, Ahab was searching Elijah to kill him. Searching to give an offering means he's very happy. Searching to give something means he's very happy. He's searching. When you read the whole chapter, he sent all his leaders and said, find this guy. If you find him, let me know. Let me come and cut his head. The Lord said, go and show yourself to Ahab. I am going to bring the rain. If the rain come means we can happily go and show. Before miracle, the Lord expected Elijah to obey. You know, in the Acts, now we all knew that, so that I didn't want to read that. The God spoke to Ananias. What God command to Ananias? Go to that place. He said the street name. First GPS in the world. Navigation. Don't go to other ways. The particular house you go, there is a man called Saul is praying. Go and pray for him. Ananias trembled. Oh my God, you know the you don't know the thing. He came to arrest me. So he informed to God, God, you know one thing. He came here to arrest me. Do you want me to go and surrender? The Lord said, no, no, no. The impossible thing is going to happen. The one who rise to destroy the church, he is going to establish. The one man's obedient. Today the Lord is expecting these things in our life, my dear brother and sister. The world is telling lot. World is giving a lot of information. One pastor today morning, he said that hereafter seeing large people in the church is impossible. What a fake statement. Nowadays, bringing the people to the kingdom of God is impossible. People are giving the statistics, 2025, this nation become Islam nation. People are coming from there. People are coming from this link. My dear brother, so one of the pastors said, my God trusting me, he is sending all the people because he knew through me they are all going to know the Jesus Christ. How many of you believe, brother? Until we are here, this nation will not under the coverage of Satan. we are here to bring the revival of God. So obedient, the believing the God's word. My dear brothers, many times we couldn't able to believe. We couldn't able to obey the Lord. To obey something, you must have peace. Then only we can able to obey. Right? Someone is telling, brother, wait here. To obey his word, I must have peace with him. Right? I must have a peace with him. Okay, if Bishop Alfonso said, there will be the purpose. I can stay. Am I right? If I said to my daughter, wait here, she must wait. She will wait because she have peace on me. My dear brothers, most of the time, we are doubting the God's word. We are doubting the God's power because we are not having peace in God. When you read 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 2, the Bible says, knowing God, our Jesus Christ, the peace and grace will increase in you. Then how much we know about God? How much we know about the power of God? One day, when I read the David Livingstone story, the beautiful thing it was written, David Livingstone, he was not done a ministry in London. He has done a ministry in the African country. He was the one draw the African map. He buried five of his children in the African forest. He was an apostle of Africa. One day, he was sleeping. Many persecutions, many people against him. Because he spoke against the slavery, he spoke against many things against the white people, British government. A lot of enemies were there. One day the Lord spoke to him, David Livingstone, run to the nearest forest. What he said? Run to the nearest forest. He thought that, oh, someone is going to hit me, someone is going to kill me. Thank God, God wants to save my life. He ran like anything. If any danger come, full fast will come, no? He ran like anything. The Lord said, go, 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 go. He almost entered to the mid of the center of the forest. Suddenly he heard the voice, my son, stop. He stopped under the tree. Oh my God, God saved my life. Then the Lord said, my son, preach about my love. Where? The middle, everywhere the tree. What, Lord? Preach my love, my son. Preach about the message of repentance. Preach. Then he's not ready to preach in full mind, you know, in the mid of the night. In the deep sleep, God woke him and said him, run to the forest. He preached something. He blabbered something. The Holy Spirit, this is not enough. Preach again. See, he preached again. The Lord said, this is not again. Preach again. He preached again. He preached again. Again, the Holy Spirit, this is not enough. Sound and preach. Fourth time he preached soundly. Fifth time the Lord said, preach. This time he lost his temper. He was very upset. He shouted like anything. He thought that let all the tigers save today. Let all the lions save today. He thought that in this forest no one is there. And after his preaching, the Lord said, lead to the sinner's prayer. No one is there. The sinner's prayer. He said the sinner's prayer. The Lord said, enough, my son, go to your bed. He was very upset and he didn't know what happened. The next day, five people came to his house and they said, we accepted Christ through your preaching. When? Yesterday night. They are the great thief in this country, in that country. They steal the people, they kill the people, they rape the people. That was their hiding place. No one knew that these people are staying there. But God decided, I have to touch these people. My dear brother, if David Livingstone couldn't believe, couldn't obey his word, what will happen, my brother? In Luke chapter 5 verse 5, we can see the obedience of Peter. Peter said, Lord, the whole night we tried, nothing we couldn't catch, but according to your word, as you said, I am putting my net. What happened, my brother? The full net filled with fishes. He caught two boat full of fishes. You just simply, you think in a worldly way, Jesus, he was a son of carpenter. Right? If carpenter give counseling to the fisherman, worldly way, is it possible? I came all the way from India. If I give a direction, London direction to you, what will you believe? Brother, I know shortcut to Eastern. Will you believe? Brother, please, Pastor. So this man, born and brought up with a carpenter. This man, born and brought up as a fisherman. He knew every corner of the sea. He knew all the technique. What he did, he threw his experience. He threw his knowledge and he submit, Lord, let me surrender your word. Today, the Lord is expecting one thing. When you believe this word of God, this will bring the revival in this nation. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 11 verse 8. Please read Hebrews chapter 11 verse 8. With this we are going to pray. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 8. By faith, Abraham, please underline the word, obeyed. Can you tell this word? Obeyed. When by faith Abraham obeyed, when he was called to go out to the place which he would receive as an inheritance, and he went out not knowing where he was going. Amen. We may not know what the Lord is going to do through your life. Let us submit ourselves. Lord, I am ready, Lord. The Lord wants to speak to Samuel. God wants to make him as a prophet to the prophet. He is going to give the prophecy to Eli, the great high priest. He is going to be the prophet. My dear brothers, so only one thing God expected from his mouth. Lord, tell me I am ready to obey. Believe the God's word, my dear brother and sister. In 2 Deuteronomy chapter 20 verse 20 says, I think so. Believe the prophets. Believe the God's word. Today let us believe the God's word. It may not, that's why the Bible says Job chapter 5 verse 9. Job chapter 9 verse 10. He is the one does all unbelievable, unmeasurable things. Today the Lord is speaking to us. Through us, God is going to do the impossible things. Amen. Only thing, we are going to believe what the Lord is telling us. Amen. So we may think that what I am going to do while I am preaching in the Eastern station. Whenever I see my brother and pastor are preaching in the street, no, in outward it looks like no one is hearing. Right? Just we are obeying what the Lord is telling to us. You know, with this testimony, I will finish. You know, in Croydon, there is a place called Carshalton. There is one brother is there. His name is Shankar. He is a very strong believer. He came from the Hindu background. He is serving the Lord as evangelist. Lots of North Indian, they are accepting God. Lot of people, they are accepting God. Every day in his house, the prayer meetings are going on. He is bringing a lot of souls to the kingdom of God. One day I asked, brother, did you know the love of God? Who preached you? Then he said, I don't know who preached me. Unknown person. Through unknown person I received the gospel. It is really, you know, make curiosity to know that. I asked, how, brother? He said, when I was studying the 10th standard, almost 15 years, he was born and brought up in the very strong Hindu city. Name called Madurai, temple city. They used to call us a temple city. He lived in the temple street. Preachers cannot enter. If any preacher, Christians comes, they will throw the stones. They will chase out from everything. But my dear brother and sister, one of the men of God, he never gave up. He decided, somewhat I am going to tell the gospel. The Lord said, go and preach them. What he decided, in that area, some people, some magicians, they used to come in the midnight. Kududubukara, how to say? Some horoscope people, no? They used to come, directly come from the graveyard. They used to come only in the midnight, 12 o'clock to 2 o'clock, their mere time. They used to go to every house and they will give some word to the house. People feared to come out and see their face. 12 to 2 o'clock, no one will not come. Every door will be shut. This man will come and tell something, and the next day morning he will come and collect the food and everything. One of the pastor, he found this time. He decided during the time, no will not come. Let me use this time. So midnight, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, So he cannot give a big preaching, because as soon as he started talking about Jesus, people will know, they will come out and chase. What he will do? Per street, one word. One street, one word, and he, after that he will run away. Right? So one particular night, that pastor came to this person's street and he said, ask, you will get it, Jesus says. He ran away. That was the message he has given. What is the message, Thambi? Such a big message or short message? Very short. Ask, you will get it, Jesus says. He ran away. After 15 years, now you become 30 years. After 15 years, when he was in a great need of finance, no one could enable to help him. He decided to finish his life. He decided to suicide. During that time, the Holy Spirit helped him to recollect this word. After 15 years, the message came back to him. Ask, you will get it, Jesus says to you. He was amazed. Oh, I worshipping millions and millions of God. But no God said that, ask, you will get it. It's my fault. I ask these gods because these gods never promise I will give if you ask. I'm very sorry. I forget to ask this God, because this God only said, ask, you will get it. Then he prayed to God, Christian God. He prayed like this, Christian God, you only said, ask, I will give it. I am asking, please give me. In that night, miracle happened. He got the money miraculously. He accepted Jesus Christ. He said, I am waiting to enter to heaven, because in heaven only Jesus will introduce who preached to me. Hallelujah. Our God is a mighty God, my dear. Obey, you will see the impossible become possible.